And now based in SF, you have worked for a whole host of companies across industries such as airlines, but you've been, of course, DocuSign being a key company, that you were chief information security officer. Now you're using your expertise to allocate capital.
Yes.
Why at Cyberstarts?
Cyberstarts has a very, very unique model. We're a very small but mighty cyber-only venture capital firm. And there's a secret sauce behind this firm. They're very small. There's three partners, two in Tel Aviv and me in San Francisco. And we each bring something very, very different. We've got entrepreneurs, we've got traditional venture capitalists, and myself being the practitioner. So when you think about bringing the operational experience to young founders that are in the very early seed stages, we forget sometimes as practitioners how much value we can actually add to these young companies to make sure that we stress test the problem statements that they have and make sure that they're building long-lasting, meaningful companies.
Founded in 2018, by Sequoia partner, but also the godfather of the Israeli cybersecurity scene. Israeli, just talk to us at the moment about how you are seeing the ecosystem affected there. You must have, of course, a large amount of portfolio companies based there.
Yes, in fact, every one of our portfolio companies is based in Israel. And there's a sadness. I mean, there's an absolute profound sadness amongst the community right now. And on a personal level, I don't think I've met a single founder that hasn't been affected in some way, whether they know somebody who has been murdered, somebody that's missing, or somebody that's been profoundly affected. So on a personal level, it struck really, really close to home for us. On a professional level, however, I am so impressed with the resilience of the Israeli people and of the Israeli startup community. It is absolutely incredible. I think this concept of business continuity and resilience is something that we talk about all the time. Israelis have this natural ability to think about what that actually means because they're used to living in turmoil. This is, of course, unprecedented. But what it means is they were prepared and able to bounce back. Now, some of the portfolio companies have had some of their staff that are now on reserve duty. There's people in the United States that are standing in for them. But business has remained relatively unaffected. I would not say it's business as usual by any stretch. But these are resilient people who really, truly have continuity plans that have gone into effect.
Geopolitics is complex. So, too, is the world in which you work with cybersecurity. And I'm wondering what, therefore, problems they are generally trying to tackle, what ways in which you're seeing your startups, your portfolios, manage to outperform it in a market context that has been very difficult.
Well, it's all about the people. I mean, our philosophy first is we invest in people. Most of the companies that we invest in haven't written a single line of code when we give them seed funding. So as I said earlier, they stress test the problem. One of our main portfolio companies, unicorn called Wiz, fastest growing software company on the planet ever, faster than Twitter, Airbnb,
Facebook. How are you measuring that?
Based on growth, so they've been around for 3 years, $10 billion valuation and over $300 million in revenue in just 3 years. So just the trajectory of the growth. Because these founders, they're some of the second time founders, so they've been there and done it before and that definitely helps. They listen to the market and have adjusted to the market very easily during times which are very tumultuous. And again, we want to make sure we're solving very real problems.
Yeah.